Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and yesterday Apple released macOS Big Sur Beta 3. This is available to developers currently and hopefully soon to public beta testers, and supports all macOS Big Sur supported devices. Now this came in at a very large 4.96 gigabytes. This is on a 2016 MacBook Pro 13 inch. And so it seems to be running okay. I'll talk more about that in a moment. But the update's fairly large, and they're usually this big when you install these beta updates for some reason. So it was normal with Catalina, it's normal with Big Sur. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. The build number is 20A5323i, and this particular update brings some changes. Now macOS Big Sur Beta 2 did not really have any changes, so I didn't do a video on it, but this one does have a few significant changes. But there are still some known issues. This is a beta, so keep that in mind. There are 36 known issues according to Apple's notes, as well as 46 resolved issues, including everything such as accessibility during setup. So voiceover and things like that have been fixed. There are a lot of fixes, 46 resolved issues. And so it's good to see that they're making a lot of progress on it. And so far it seems pretty good. Now, as far as the new features, well, the first thing is some new sounds. So for example, if I take a screenshot by holding Command Shift 3, you can hear that the sound is a little bit different. Now I'll do that again. They've changed that sound. Now, if we go into screenshots and I delete that photo, you'll see or hear that the trash is a little bit different. If I hit Command Z and take it out of the trash, there's another sound. So they've changed sounds all over the place. Most notably, the screenshot sound is what most people have noticed, but that's something they've changed. Now, the next thing, people will be very happy to know that Apple has updated the battery icon. The battery icon in the previous version looked like this. So let's go ahead and open it up so I can show you side by side. So this is from beta 1 and beta 2, the previous battery icon. The battery now looks like this. It's what we would expect the battery to look like, an actual battery instead of, some people have called this a baby bottle. I've heard other things as well. So you'll see it gives the charging status. It looks like a normal battery like you'd expect. And then you just have the same icons here for things like battery, power adapter, and schedule, your usage history, your battery health. And so you can go in and check all of these things out. So it's really great to see they've changed this. I'm looking forward to them changing some other icons as well. But the next thing that they've changed is the music icon, which is pretty obvious. They've updated it to match iOS 14 beta 3, where we saw that new update. And you'll see it says the music volume is currently turned all the way down. And it's just letting me know. And it's taking a while to bring up Listen Now for whatever reason. Maybe we'll go to Browse. Sometimes this is a little bit buggy, but you'll see it says updating cloud music library. And then another new thing they've changed is the play button. It looks a little bit different. We don't know if this is a mistake or if it's just to match the way it looks in line. We're not really sure yet, but this definitely is different than what we had before. So that's something that's different. They've also updated the dictionary icon. So if we go into Launchpad here, you'll see dictionary here. Previously, it looked a little bit different than this. Let me show you side by side. And you can see this is someone named Nico on Twitter, and you can follow him if you want to see some of the changes, but you'll see there's a little change here. This is the old icon on the left. Here's the new one on the right with macOS Big Sur Beta 3 that we have here. So those are the major changes within this particular update. There is not a whole lot new. Now, some people were saying that the battery remaining isn't showing, although I am seeing it while charging. When the device is not charging, it may not show how much time is remaining. That's something some people are seeing. But there is one more new feature that Apple has added, and that is APFS formatted backup volume. So if you're using Time Machine should be a lot faster now because it's using APFS instead of HFS, which was the previous version. Apple says it makes for faster, more compact, and more reliable backups. It says new local and network Time Machine backup destinations are formatted as APFS by default. But if it actually already is formatted in HFS, it will continue in that version or that option. So you may have to select a new disk in order to get that to work. And that is all of the new changes in this particular version. Now, as far as performance goes, so far it's been pretty good. You've seen I'm recording the screen while actually making this video, and it seems to be pretty responsive. We did have that one issue with music not loading properly, but that could be something else entirely. although everything else seems to be fairly fast right now, but I would expect performance improvements closer to the final release. Now, if you found anything else new, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below if you've seen anything else. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll leave a link to it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.